Okay, students, so now today class number 19. So already class number 18 we explained the one of the problem to find out the tangent and equation which are parallel to the given line. So now another method to find out the tangent and equation. I am explaining in this class to find out the tangent and equation with using the some particular formula. Okay. So now this is the problem. Find the equation of the tangents to the circle which are parallel to this line. Of course. So we have to find out the tangent by using the tangent line form. So for the parallel lines, there is no change in the constant. Differ only constants, both slopes are equal. Now here, so this is the circle. Yes, we comparing the circle with the general form, then we getting the values g comma f and the center coordinates here 2 comma minus 3. Here radius is equal to 5. Yes, now we have to find out the tangent. The equation of the given line, the given line L is equals to x plus 2y minus 5. Yes, whose slope? The slope of this line M is equals to minus 1 by 2. Yes, students, we know this. So, we remember this, the slope of the line in the form of ax plus by plus c. Here, minus x coefficient by y coefficient. Yes, minus x coefficient here 1, y coefficient here 2, M is equals to minus 1 by 2. Yes. Now, the tangent line equation to the given circle, so parallel to given line is given by y minus of f y plus f m of x plus z plus r minus r into root of 1 plus m square. Now students, here this is the formula for finding the tangent line equation to the circle, so which are parallel to the given line. Whenever we know this, the slope and the center of the circle and the radius, then we have to write the tangent line equations. Y plus f is equal to m of x plus z plus r minus r of root of 1 plus m. Here putting all these values in this. Here students, here we know this. Y f is equals, here f is equals 3. Y plus 3 is equals to, here m, the slope of the line is minus 1 by 2. Yes. Of x plus z, here x is equal to g is equals to here minus 2, here x minus 2, plus r minus r is equal to 5, r is equals to 5, under root of 1 plus m square, m is equals to minus 1 by 2 whole square, here 1 by 4. Now in this simplification, y plus 3 is equals to minus 1 by 2 of x minus 2 plus r minus. Yeah, taking the LCM 4 plus 1, 5. Yes, 5 root 5 by under root of 4 is equal to 2. Yeah, taking the LCM 2 and cross multiplication, this will becomes 2y plus 6 is equals to minus x, minus of minus plus 2, plus r minus 5 root 5. Here, students, and after simplification here, so 2y plus 6. Here we separating these variables here. Minus x we taking in LHS side as x plus 2y. Yes, x plus 2y. And here this is the 2. Here 6. 2 minus 6 is equals to minus 4 or plus 4. In this 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. Here plus or minus 5 root 5 is equal to 0. Yes, students. Here this is the required tangent line equations to the circle which are parallel to the given line. Of course, this is the another method. So here this whenever we know this, the slope and the central coordinates and the radius of the circle, yes, we have to apply this formula also, or otherwise by using the by using the tangent condition. Yes. Yes, students. Now this is the one of the problem in the exercise 1C, question number 3. Yes, the problem is find the equation of the circle with the center coordinates here -2, 3, cutting a chord length of 2 units upon the line 3x plus 4y plus 4 is equal to 0. Here students, it is given that the center of the circle coordinates are given and the length of the chord is given. Here then we have to find out the radius and after that to write the circle equation in the standard form. And this is the one of the rough diagram here. Yes, the circle S is equal to 0. Your center coordinates, the center coordinates here -2, 3. Yes, -2, 3. Yes, we consider the center coordinates here as x1, y1, whatever it may be. Okay, and this is the line. The line cuts the circle at 2 points. Yes, the line equation here, the 3x plus the 4y plus 4 is equal to 0. Yeah, the length of the chord, yeah, the length of the distance between A and B, the length of the chord upon the line AB is equal to 2 units. Yes, here AB is equal to 2 units. Now taking the, so -2, 3, taking the foot of the perpendicular drawn from the center upon the chord, that is equal to P. But AB is equal to 2 units, but AB and PB of length of the chord, because the P is the midpoint of AB. Here this one is 1, here also 1. Now, here this is the radius of the circle. Yes, now we have to find out the radius of the circle. And we have to find out the D also. Yes, we know this AB. AB is the off length of the chord. Length of the chord AB is equal to 2 units. Off length is equal to 1 units. Okay. Now we have to find out the radius and before that the perpendicular distances. Okay. Now, here in this, to find out this. So, already we know this, the length of the chord. So, length of the chord AB is equal to 2 units and so given that the center of the circle, coordinates Q is equals to -2, 3. Yes, we consider as x1, y1. Okay. And here radius, we don't know. The radius of the circle is equal to R. And here, so D is what? The perpendicular distance. Distance from Q is equals to -2, 3 to the line L is equals to 3x plus 4y plus 4 is equal to 0. Yes, now we have to calculate the D by using the perpendicular distance formula. Yes, 3 of -2. Yes, 4 of 3 plus 4 by root of here 9 plus 16. Yes, in this simplification here, the modulus of -6 plus 12 plus 4 by root 25 is equal to 5. Yes, 12 plus 4, 16, 16 minus 6 is 10. Yes, 10 by 5 is equal to 2. Yes, D is equal to 2. And the length of the chord, is given by here AB is equal to 2 units. Yes, friends, we know this, the formula for writing the length of the chord is given by the formula AB is equal to 2 of under root of R square minus D square. In this relation, here we know this AB, yes, and R, and so we don't know R and D. We know this D. In this implication, we have to find out the D. We have to find out the R. Yes. AB is equal to 2. 2 is equal to 2 into root of R square minus D square. Here 2 cancels, squaring on both sides. 1 is equal to R square minus D square. Yes. 1 plus D square is equal to R square. Yes. R square is equal to 1 plus. Yeah, d is equal to 2, 2 square is equal to 4, yes, r square is equal to 5. So students, the circle equation here. So the circle equation. Whenever we know this, the center coordinates and the radius of the circle equation is x minus x1 whole square plus y minus y1 whole square is equal to r square. Yes, x minus. X1 is equal to center of the minus 2, minus of minus plus x plus 2 whole square plus y minus y1, y1 is equal to 3, y minus 3 whole square. Here r square is equal to 5. Here after expansion of this, yes, I am expanding this equation here. Yes, friends, we listen it. So x plus 2 whole square here, x square plus 4x plus 4, yes, y minus 3 whole square, here y square minus. So 6y plus 9 and minus 5 is equal to 0, taking the 5 in LHS ideas. In this implication, x square plus y square plus 4x minus 6y. Here 9 plus 4, yes, here 9 minus 5 is equal to, so 4, yes, 4 plus 4 is equal to 8. 8 is equal to 0. This is the required circle equation. X square plus y square plus 4x minus 6y plus 8 is equal to 0. Here once again, in this problem, to given that the center coordinates and the length of the rod upon the line. So these are the given conditions. Then we have to find out the radius. So by using this formula, the length of the chord AB is equal to 2 into r square minus d square. In this relation, here r square is equal to 5. Here we know this, the center coordinates and the radius. Then we have to write the circle equation in the standard form. X minus x1 whole square plus y minus y1 whole square is equal to r square. And after simplification, this is the required circle equation. Okay, students, yeah, this is the exercise 1C, question number 4. So, find the equation of the tangent and normal at the point 3, 2 of the circle. X square plus y square minus x minus 3y minus 4 is equal to 0. Here already, so we did this problem, write the tangent and the normal in previous classes at that point of contact. Yes. Now, here this is the rough diagram. Now, this is the tangent line and this is the normal line. Here, center of the circle and the point of contact. It is the tangent and it is the normal. Yes, is the both are perpendicular to each other. Yes, students, here first we have to find out the tangent line equation and after that, normal line equation. Yes, the given circle. The given circle equation. The given circle equation is S is equal to x square plus y square minus x minus 3y minus 4 is equal to 0. Yes, and here in this the point of contact. Here we comparing this equation with the general form of the circle. Yes, we comparing with x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Then we got 2g is equal to minus 1 and 2f is equal to minus 3 and c is equal to minus 4. G is equal to minus 1 by 2. F is equal to minus 3 by 2. Yes. Now, so the tangent line equation. The tangent line equation to the circle S is equal to 0 at the given point of contact. P of x1 comma y1 is equal to 3 comma 2 is S1 is equal to 0. Yes, students, this is the tangent line equation to the circle at the given point of contact S1. Yes, S1 of the given circle, yes, xx1 plus yy1. In this, your g of x plus x1 plus g of x plus x1 plus f of y plus y1 plus c is equal to 0. Here we should write directly also xx1. Here x1 is equal to point of contact x coordinate here 3. Here plus y of y1 is equal to 2 plus g. Here g is equals to minus. Yes, minus 1 by 2 of x plus x1, 3. And f here minus, minus 3 by 2 of y plus y1 is equal to 2. Here constant here c is equals to minus 4. Yes, students. Here the s1 of the given circuit, we should write directly xx1 plus y by 1. Here minus, in this x coefficient here 1, it's of e 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2 of x plus x1. Minus 3 by 2 of y plus y1. Minus 4 is equal to 0. Yes. Now its implication. Now taking the LCM here 2. Yes. Taking the LCM here 2. Here 3 to the 6x plus 2 to the 4y. Yes. Minus x minus 3. Here minus 3y. Minus 3y. Minus 6. Minus 8 is equal to 0. Here 6x 4y. Minus x minus 3. Here minus 3y. Minus 3 to the 6. Here 4 to the 8. And its implication is given by 6x minus x, 5x, 5x, and 4y minus 3y plus y, plus y. And constants, we simplify the constants here. So, minus 6 minus 3 minus 9, minus 9 minus 8 minus 17. Yes, minus 17. Here, it is the tangent and equation to the circle. So, at the point of contact 3 comma 2. Okay. And normal line. So, normal line equation. The normal line equation. Already we know this. For writing the normal line equation is given by the formula. Yes, x minus x1 by x1 plus z is equals to y minus y1 by y minus y1 by y1 plus z. Students, we know this, the normal line equation in terms of the point of contact and the center of the circle. So, coordinates yx minus x1 by x1 plus z is equals y minus y1 by y1 plus f. And putting all these values here. So, x minus x1 is equals to 3 by 3 plus g is equals to minus 1 by 2. Yes, plus or minus 1 by 2. Yes, y minus y1 is equal to 2. Yes, 2 plus f is equals to minus. Yes, f is equals to minus. Minus, so 3 by 2. I mean this simplification. We are taking the LCM here 2, 3, 2, 6 minus 1, 5. Yes, in this x minus 3 by. So 6 minus 5 by 2. 5 by 2 is equals to here 2 to the 4. 4 minus 3. So 1. Yes, y minus 2 by 1 by 2. Here both those are cancelled, cross multiplication here. X minus 3 is equals to here 5 y minus 10. 5 y minus 10. X minus 5 y minus 3 plus 10. So finally, normal line equation x minus 5 y plus 7 is equal to 0. So tangent line equation is 5x plus 5, 5x plus y minus 17. Normal line equation, x minus 5y plus 7. Just friends, we observe this, both are perpendicular. Its slope is minus 5, its slope is 1 by 5. The product of the slopes is equals to minus 1. Okay, so students, you have to write the normal line, you have to get in the normal line in another process or there. Here, whenever we know this, the tangent line, its perpendicular form is also normal form. Okay. So,